A Voice That Moves the Doorpost, Part 2. In Part 1, using the case of the seraphim in Isaiah chapter 6 verses 1 to 4, we started looking at how we can acquire a voice that is respected by both heaven and hell. We said that the seraphim exhibited knowledge of God and humility towards Him. We noted that anyone who wants to be recognized and respected by both God and the forces of hell must seek to know God and also humble himself before Him. We also looked at some of the ways we can develop or increase our knowledge of God. Isaiah chapter 6 verse 2. Above it stood the seraphim. Each one had six wings. With twain he covered his face, and with twain he covered his feet, and with twain he did fly. The seraphims covered their faces with two of their wings, and then covered their feet with two others. Now Proverbs chapter 1 verses 10 to 16. My son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not. If they say, come with us, let us lay wait for blood. Let us look privily for the innocent without cause. Let us swallow them up alive as the grave, and whole as those that go down into the pit. We shall find all precious substance. We shall fill our houses with spoil. Cast in thy lot among us. Let us all have one cause. My son, walk not thou in the way with them. Refrain thy foot from their path. For their feet run to evil, and make haste to shed blood. And in Proverbs chapter 6 verse 18, feet that are swift in running to mischief are listed among the seven things that are abomination to our God. We all need to cover our feet from the dust that will contaminate and make them unfit to stand before the King of Kings. Instead of allowing the world, the flesh, or the devil to order yourselves into evil, let the prayer of the psalmist in Psalm 119 verse 133 be your heart cry. Order my steps in thy word, and let not any iniquity have dominion over me. Make conscious efforts with the help of the Holy Spirit to refrain your feet from every evil way so that you can keep God's word. Psalm 119 verse 101. Do not forget that it is the word you know that the Lord will use to order your steps. Get into the word. Isaiah chapter 6 verse 2 also says that with two of their wings, the seraphims did fly. Remember that people who fly high often get misunderstood and called different kinds of unkind names. They are sometimes abandoned and alone. Being misunderstood and left alone can be unpalatable, but it is better to go through that unpalatable situation and be on God's side than to become a companion of fools. This is because, according to Proverbs 13:20, a companion of fools shall be destroyed. A fool, by the way, is a person who deliberately walks contrary to the will of God, as if God will never judge and punish sinners. 1 Corinthians 15:33, be not deceived, evil communication corrupts good manners. Isaiah chapter 6 verse 3, and one cried unto another and said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. If you want a voice that moves the doorpost, you must learn to acknowledge and glorify God. Proverbs 3:6 says we should acknowledge him in all our ways. This involves believing that God is truly who he says he is and allowing him to carry out in our lives everything he says that he can. It also involves trusting God to the point of walking exactly as he wants us to. When you acknowledge God, you are actually honoring him, and he said in 1 Samuel 2:30 that he will honor those that honor him. One of the ways he honors his own is by making their voice respectable in heaven and in hell. What happens when you have a voice that moves the doorpost? You carry authority with God. 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 1. And Elijah the Tishbite, who was of the inhabitants of Gilead, said unto Ahab, as the Lord God of Israel liveth, before whom I stand, there shall not be dew nor rain these years, but according to my word. Also, consider what happened in 1 Samuel 12:16 to 18, while Samuel was rebuking and admonishing the children of Israel. Now therefore, stand and see this great thing which the Lord will do before your eyes. Is it not wheat harvest today? I will call unto the Lord, and he shall send thunder and rain, that you may perceive and see that your wickedness is great, which ye have done in the sight of the Lord in asking you a king. So Samuel called unto the Lord, and the Lord sent thunder and rain that day, and all the people greatly feared the Lord and Samuel. How many present-day Christians, or even so-called pastors, can speak as boldly as Elijah and Samuel did in the name of the Lord in the open? Probably most Christians will not be that bold. They will be afraid that God will not answer them, just like God refused to answer Saul in 1 Samuel 28:6. Many would even be afraid of getting the kind of results that the sons of Sceva got in Acts 19:13 to 16, because they know very well that their lives are not right before God. After all, it is the righteous that is as bold as a lion, according to Proverbs 28, verse 1. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.